Decepticons.
Fuck-ass lamb. Already talking shit.
First off, let me state this. Anybody that says St. Louis Lambs or L.A. Lambs or whatever, do you even know the difference between a lamb and a ram? Until you know that, watch your mouth, bro.
Telling the difference between a sheep and a goat is pretty basic. For one thing, goats generally don't have a woolly coat. They have a hairy coat. The other thing is that goats, both male and female, usually have a beard. His beard has been trimmed quite a bit, but they have a beard. Sheep don't have beards. The other feature, if we turn him around, we will look at his tail. You can see, turn around, Roscoe, that his tail is up. Sheep tails, I'm going to let him go. A sheep tail is always down. A goat tail, see, here's her little tail. She always carries her tail down. Goats can carry them down or up, but often they flag them up like that. And that's how you can tell the basic differences between a sheep and a goat. Horns are somewhat, if they have horns, usually they're a goat at this point, because most of our domestic sheep, except for merinos, really don't carry horns.
But we can't hear them.
Step your education up.
You know why? Because these motherfuckers are all the way in the basement.
Woo.
Trying to scream.
All the way in the basement? You right next to us. You upstairs, bruh. You tied up with the retardinals. How is you talking about, oh, we don't hear y'all? Motherfucker, I get my broomstick and bang on the roof, and y'all motherfuckers finna hear us. Please believe that. We finna be knocking down your motherfucking door this Sunday. We finna be knocking your motherfucking teeth out on the field on Sunday. Oh!
Is your hairline receding? Are you thinning out on top? Is that bald spot getting bigger by the minute?
You went way harder than you came.
We got real head busters over here, motherfucker. So get your shit straight.
You don't got no head busters over there.
Yeah, who the hell?
Stop. 13. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. That's 9 weeks ago. Why are you talking about like 2 months ago, bruh? Really? Like, why is you talking 2 months ago? The same team that you faced in week four is not the same team that's coming into your house and finna whoop that ass this Sunday.
One or more of these scenarios.
Alright, alright.
Get your back straight there, brother. What you know about it? Continue with this bullshit. Period blood? We ain't worried about that. That's gonna be spewed all over the field when we whoop that ass.
Do people have to wear sunglasses just to talk to you? Does the shine from your scalp confuse airline pilots when they're trying to land? Are you tired of sweeping the 5 or 6 hairs you have over to try to hide your baldness? Have you been so desperate that you've even tried hair in a can?
Squire, will you hurry?
If any of these things happen to you, then we've got the product you've been looking for, Bald Ease. This revolutionary pill is an all-new, all-natural, artificial, herbal supplement that will give you the look you want. No more hair transplants.
You ain't repping shit for life. You just showed up in probably 2005. Stop, bro. Or else you's an 80 bandwagon fan. Or else you's a Steve Young bandwagon jumper. Come on, bro.
I gotta close the window before I record, because New York don't know how to be quiet. Yeah. Stand up. Third.
Coochie down to the socks like I'm Biggie Popper. Baby. Keep your
your girl head in my Tommy boxes. But when it out, she a silly hoe, cause she know the freaking slide getting plenty dough. She don't get nothing from my nigga though. Once she get his hard dick and some Cheerios, kinda send it out, but I never go. But I put him in a dirt with the penny low. No tint though, on my window, so you see a nigga shining in a Benzo. Got me feeling like Jim Jones. I'm a pimp though, no limp though. Couldn't copy my style in Kinko's. Put in work, run up on the killer, then I put him in the dirt. Run up in the building, see me gon' squirt. That's what a nigga get when they gettin' on my nerves. I ain't lying. Lay him on that curb, riding on the killer who be coming that firm. Girl, you twerk, twerk that kitty girl, make it turn. Put in work, Flacco, put him in the dirt. Push, got the shovel, he gon' put him in the earth. Trinidad maniac with the all gon' hurt. Yeah, put in work. Schoolboy Q with a pound of the perk. So much work, he'll smoke up the earth. Pull no brown, ASAP,
that ain't Kanye, nope, that's Montana, loose cannon.
What's going on, Niner Empire, TTC, it's your boy Danny G, SFG TV. Now, Rockstar Rams, aka Money Mike, as you used to go by that on here. I played most of your video at the beginning of mine, and let me just get right into everything you said. Now, first off, you got mad at Megatron for bringing up the LA Rams, St. Louis Rams, you know, difference. Well, let me tell you something. You know, you can say all you want about the fact that you think that the Rams are coming back to LA in 2015. Until that actually happens, you're the St. Louis Rams, and there ain't nothing you can fucking do about it. You're the St. Louis Rams, and you will be until you actually are playing in LA. Which I don't really think is going to happen, because it's hard for me to see LA ever having a team again. Which is kind of a joke, because, you know, one of the biggest cities in... second biggest city in the country, but, and, you know, the team that you're cheering for, Rockstar Rams, and any Rams fan in the TTC, because I've never seen a single, in my 4 years of being in the TTC, I have not seen a single Rams fan from St. Louis. All of them are local to LA. All of them I have seen. So, the team that you guys have been cheering for doesn't even exist. How does that make you feel? Seriously, the team, the Los Angeles Rams, doesn't even exist. You're the St. Louis Rams. And Rockstar Rams, if you're watching this video, then what I want you to do is this. It's going to be a little bit of a bet. When you guys come to Candlestick and we beat you this Sunday, you can never mention the term Los Angeles Rams in your video until the Lambs are playing in LA, which probably will never happen. Anyway, enough of that. Now, what I was doing this week is I was trying to decide whether I want to start Frank Gore or No Sean Marino. Now, Frank Gore is, you know, my favorite Niner, but he didn't do that well against the Redskins. So I thought, well, maybe I could start No Sean Marino, and I would also start Pierre Thomas this week. But then I saw it say something. I saw it say that the St. Louis Rams gave up the fourth most fantasy points to running backs. The fourth most fantasy points to running backs are given up by the St. Louis Rams. So, am I scared of your defense? No. Now, your quarterback, Sam Bradford, probably the biggest bust in the NFL, with a small exception of Blaine Gabbert. So, I'm not really scared of your team at all. And, Rockstar Rams, you say that the team that's coming into Candlestick this Sunday is not the same team that we played week 4? Well, explain to me how you're a different team, because really, I don't really, I mean, you might have a little bit of a better record, but I don't see how you guys are any different or any better of a team. Now, whenever you guys have our number, whenever you guys beat us, it seems, it's always at your house. And this year, we already took care of that week four and whooped your ass. So, this week, this Sunday, at Candlestick, you guys don't stand a chance. Anyway, that's all I got. I'm out. Niner Empire, one team, one family, one goal. I'm out. Peace.